Morning, dear students. Okay, shall we move on to our class? Okay, we have already learned the property, that is closure property of addition and multiplication. Last class we had discussed the topic. So the second condition, that second property, conditions for addition and multiplication. What is the condition of addition? A plus B equal to B plus A. Okay, in closure property also we have learned the conditions. Like that, we have the conditions in other properties. So, A plus B is equal to B plus A. Okay, then multiplication, A into B equal to B into A. The commutative property is only closed under addition and multiplication. It is not closed under subtraction and division. Okay. So, this is the two conditions. Let's we check. First one is A is equal to 2. B is equal to 3. Okay. I am taking these two numbers. A is equal to 2 and B is equal to 3. First, I am going to check the first condition. Okay. The first condition I am taking. What is the value of A plus B? A plus B. That is 2 plus 3. Equal to B plus A. What is B plus A? 3 plus 2. So, 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. Equal to 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. So, the answer is equal. Isn't it? The answer is equal. So, the commutative property is closed under addition. Let's we check it for multiplication. A into B. What is A into B? 2 into 3 equal to 3 into 2. That is 2 into 3 is equal to 6. 3 into 2 is equal to 6. So the condition is same. Okay. So this is the commutative property. This is the condition. First one, addition and multiplication, same conditions. Symbols only will be changed. So, A plus B, 2 plus 3, B plus A, 3 plus 2. If we got the same answer, it will be closed under addition as well as multiplication. Okay. So, next property is, that is third property. You can see the third property, that is associative property. What is the third property? Associative. Okay. Associative property. So, what is associative property? First condition. The condition of associative property is A plus B plus C. That is for addition. Okay. A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. This is the condition for addition. So, we have to write the another number. C is equal to 4. Okay, I am taking C is equal to 4. So, let's we check the symbol. A plus B plus C. What is the value of A? 2 plus 3 plus 4. 2 plus 3 plus 4 is equal to A plus B. That is 2 plus 3 plus 4. Okay, so first one, 2 plus 3 plus 4 is equal to, yes, 7. Then 2 plus 3 is equal to 5 plus 4. So 2 plus 7, what will be the answer? 9 is equal to 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. So the conditions is same. Okay, these two conditions are same. Okay. So, equal, so that we can say the associative property is closed under addition. Okay, let's we check the conditions for the multiplication. Okay, if we got the same answer like this, then we can say it as closed under multiplication. So, I am just changing the symbol. Then, I am going to check the numbers. First one, 2 into 3 3 into 4 is equal to a into b. That is 2 into 3 into 4. So first one, 2 into. What is 3 into 4? 3 into 4 is equal to 12. Is equal to 3 twos are 6. 6 into 4. Then what is the value of 12 into 2? That is nothing but 24. 6 fours are 24. So the answer is equal. So the associative property is closed under multiplication. Okay, is it clear? Is it clear for addition as well as the multiplication? First we learn the closure property, then second one is the commutative property, third one is associative property. Okay, is it clear all of you? Yes. Okay, then the last and final property, that is nothing but distributive property. What is distributive property? Last one is distributive. Distributive property. What is distributive property? Okay. What is distributive property? We have one condition. That is nothing but A into B plus C. There is only one condition in the distributive property. That is A into B plus C is equal to A into B. A into B plus A into C. That is nothing but A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. A into B. Okay, that is the first. Then plus A into C. We are multiplying the first number with these two numbers. So A into B, that is plus A into C. Okay, is it clear? Okay. Now A equal to 2 and B is equal to 3 and C is equal to 4. If we have to find the answer, okay, if you have to find the answer, should write 2 into 3 plus 4. We cannot take that two conditions. Is it true or not? For distributive property. So first we can take 2 into 3 plus 4. Then that is equal to A into B. If you are going to find the answer, we are only finding this. Then you have to find the answer. For distributive property, so A into B. What is A into B? A is equal to 2 and 3. 2 into 3 plus 2 into 4. So 2 into 4. 2 into 3 is equal to 6 plus 4 into 2 is equal to 8. 4 twos are 8, 3 twos are 6. So 8 plus 6 is equal to 14. 8 plus 6 is equal to 14. So the answer is 14. How we have find the answer? Through distributive property. Okay. Is it clear all of you? If you are having the question, that is the question model will be find the answer or find the distributive property condition. Find through distributive property or associative property, commutative property, like that the questions will be having. You should check what is the property, then you have to write the condition and then you have to find out the answer. Okay, is it clear? Okay, so first I am going to tell once again the properties. Okay, first one is closure property. First one is closure property. This is the first one. Closure property is nothing but if you are having A, B belongs to W. This is the symbol of belongs to. Okay. This is the symbol of belongs to. Okay. So this is the symbol. So I am writing A, B belongs to W. That is W that denotes whole numbers. So a and b belongs to whole number, then a plus b is equal to c, that should belongs to w. Okay, this is the condition for addition. Then multiplication, a into b is equal to, that is a into b is equal to c belongs to w. These are the two conditions for the closure property. Only two conditions are satisfied. Closure property is also closed under addition and multiplication. It is not closed under subtraction and division. So next one, what is the second one? Commutative. So commutative property, what is the condition for addition? Commutative property condition is a plus b is equal to b plus a. So a plus b equal to b plus a. This is the condition for addition. Then the condition for multiplication, a into b equal to b into a. These are the two conditions for the commutative property. So then what is the third property? After commutative, third property is nothing but it is an associative. Nothing but associative property. So what is associative property? Associative property condition is a plus b plus c is equal to a plus b plus c. Okay, this is the condition of associative. For multiplication, a into b into c is equal to a into b into c. Okay, these are the conditions for the associative of closed under addition as well as multiplication. So last and final, that is distributive. What is the property? Distributive property. So the distributive property is nothing but a into b plus c is equal to a into b plus a into c. Okay, this is nothing but a into b is equal to a into b plus a into c. So these are the conditions of the properties, that is closure property. A b belongs to the whole number, a plus b is equal to c, a into b is equal to c, the c should be in whole number. Commutative property, a plus b equal to b plus a. If we satisfy these conditions, it is closed under addition and multiplication. Then associative, a plus b plus c is equal to a plus b plus c. Okay, only the brackets are getting changed. For distributive, only one conditions are there, a into b plus c is equal to a into b plus a into c. Okay, these are the four properties. You should learn these conditions. Write down these conditions neatly in your notebook. Then you can easily find out the answer. Okay, is it clear all of you? I hope all have understood today's class. So only four properties are that we learned today. So the condition should be learned, then only you can prepare easily or you can find answer easily. Okay, so we can meet in the next class. Thank you.